Amen. He reigns. Amen. I want us to look at Matthew 10 and 37 through 39. It says, he who loves father or mother more than worthy of me. And he who loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he who does not take his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for my sake will find it. You see, Jesus is calling us to a very deep consecration with him. And hearing his word and worshiping him, well, that changes us. It changes our hearts, amen? Changes our viewpoints, our perspective, changes how we love. Our vision here this year is knowing God, loving people, and empowering life. Hearing God's word in preaching and singing and worship, that changes who we are. It's the worship that draws us near to God to know him more. And that changes us so that we can love people. Yes. That empowers our life to be his true disciples. Yes. So change me, Lord. Can we say that together? Can we say, change me, Lord? Change me, Lord. Is that your prayer? Amen. Psalms 51 and 10 says, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Can we read that together? Let's read that together. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Amen. Let's make that our prayer. Lord, empty me of the world so that there's room for you. Amen. Amen. Let me become broken so that you can make me whole, truly whole. Let me lose my will in yours. Please keep making me. Do not cast me from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Worship together as we sing, Keep Making Me.
Make me move.